Liberal nationalism, many nationalist movements in the world are dedicated to national liberation in the view that their nations are being persecuted by other nations, and thus the need to exercise self-determination by liberating themselves from the accused persecutors. Anti-revisionist Marxist Leninism is closely tied with this ideology, and practical examples include Stalin's early work Marxism and National Question and his Socialism in One Country Edict, which declares that nationalism can be used in an international context, that is, fighting for national liberation without racial or religious divisions. In the economic sphere, liberalism stood for the freedom of market and abolition of state-imposed restrictions on the movements of goods and capital. During the 19th century, there was a strong demand of the emerging middle classes. A new conservatism after 1815. Following the defeat of Napoleon in 1815, European governments were driven by a spirit of conservatism. Conservatives believed that established traditional institutions of state and society, like the monarchy, the church, social hierarchies, property, and the family, should be preserved. Most conservatives, however, did not propose a return to the society of pre-revolutionary days. They realized from the changes initiated by Napoleon that modernization could in fact strengthen the traditional institutions like the monarchy. It could make the state power more effective and strong. A modern army, an efficient bureaucracy, a dynamic economy, the abolition of feudalism and serfdom could strengthen the autocratic monarchies of Europe. The revolutionaries, during the years following 1815, the fears of repression drove many liberal nationalists underground. Secret societies sprang up in many European states to train the revolutionaries and to spread their ideas. To be revolutionary at this time meant a commitment to oppose the monarchical forms that had been established after the Vienna Congress and to fight for liberty and freedom. Most of the revolutionaries also saw the creation of nation states. The year of revolutions, 1830 to 1848, liberalism and nationalism, it came to be increasingly associated with revolution in many regions of Europe, such as the Italian and German states, the provinces of the Ottoman Empire, Ireland and Poland. These revolutions were led by the liberal nationalists belonging to the educated middle class elite, among whom were professors, school teachers, clerks, and members of the commercial middle classes. The first disturbance took place in France in July 1830. The Bourbon kings had been restored to power during the conservative reaction after 1815. They were now overthrown by the liberal revolutionaries, who installed a constitutional monarchy with Louis Philippe as the head. The July Revolution, it sparked an uprising in the Brussels, which led to Belgium breaking away. The growth of revolutionary nationalism in Europe sparked off a struggle for independence among the Greeks, which began in 1821. Nationalists in Greece, they got support from the other Greeks living in exile and also from many West Europeans who had sympathies for ancient Greek culture. Poets and artisans, they lauded the Greece as the cradle.